Hi and welcome to the third video in the Sabas Cakes how-to. Today I'm going to make a simple sponge cake, and in the middle of the sponge cake, as normal, which I like, is going to have buttercream and jam in the middle. It's an actual birthday cake that I'm making, and it's going to be in shape of a suit, tie and shirt. These are the ingredients that I will be using for a basic sponge. Sugar, flour, a little bit of milk, butter, margarine, eggs and baking powder. I don't have any vanilla essence, but what I'm going to use instead is disaronno. It's got a quite unique flavour to it. So this is the tray that I'm going to be baking the cake in. It's an average turkey or potato roasting tray. I don't have the actual baking trays, but this is just as good. Also, to weigh the ingredients, the scales, and this is my own little book. I put all the recipes, my favorite recipes, in there that I like, and I'll be using double the mixture that I have in here for the sponge cake. And also, unlike last time, I hand mixed the cake, or with a whisk. I actually, thank you to my husband, I actually bought Kenwood Chef. I'm very happy for this because it's not only quick, it saves a lot of time. So this is what I'll be using today. First I will weigh out the margarine. The recipe requires for 250 grams, but as I'm doubling the mixture, I'll use 500 grams. So I'll just quickly weigh this out. Butter, margarine, whichever you use, should be at room temperature. Makes it easier to mix. So that's 500 grams, and now add this to the Kenwood. Just chop up the butter a little bit. And put the butter in the mixer. Okay, and that's the butter inside. I won't start any mixing on the butter yet, I'll wait till the sugar is weighed out. Also, the recipe calls for 250 grams, but like I'm doubling in the mixture, 500 grams of sugar. And add it to the butter. So now it's time to mix the butter and the sugar together. And I'll put it on a slow setting first. What I'm aiming for this is a light, fluffy consistency. As you can see, the mixture tends to stick to the sides, so just get your spatula, scrape down the sides, so everything is mixed in. As you can see, it's looking light already. Just a little bit more mixing, and then we'll add the other ingredients, or weigh out the other ingredients, I should say. Mixed, and I'm happy with the how it looks. It's fluffy, creamy and light. I can get the other ingredients ready. The recipe is 8 eggs, incorporate the yolks. The ingredients ask for 4 tablespoons of milk. So I'm going to add that to the egg mixture. And I'm also going to add the disaronno to the egg and milk mixture. And then just mix that. Take a little bit of time. I'm going to put it separately in this bowl here before I add it to the Kenwood and the mixture of the butter and sugar. So just a little bit at a time in the sieve. And there you have it, the flour is sifted and ready to mix into the butter and the sugar mixture with the eggs as well. So flour is sifted and ready, and we're going to add the 8 teaspoons of baking powder. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8. A little stir. And a little bit at a time, I'm going to blend the mixture of the eggs and the flour equally into the Kenwood mixture with the butter and the sugar. So, 1 spoon full of flour. A little bit of eggs. As I go along, just add a little bit of flour and eggs, even as it's mixing. So I'll turn on the mixer right now. To 1 is enough, until all the mixture is in, and then I'll put it on a higher speed, and as I go along with the spatula, get all the mixture into the bowl. So now I will scrape the mixture from the sides and let everything mix together, incorporate together nicely. And now it's ready to mix. That will be the final mixture. Again, I'll put it on a higher mix and just leave it for a little while. In the meantime, I'm going to set the oven and I'm going to set the tray so it's ready for the cake mixture to go in. Ingredients is all mixed in, looking very nice. Getting ready to put it in the baking tin. Shake off the ingredients from the whisk. It's ready to wash. Very nice and creamy. I'm going to add it to the baking tin. The flour and the butter is in the so the cake won't stick to the sides of the tin. More at the sides, because as it goes in the oven the mixture melts and you don't want a cake that is bulky in the middle. The cake is now ready to go into the oven. I've set the oven at 200 degrees and I'll check it every so often. It should take about 45 minutes, and I'll check it every so often after the 45 minutes, and if it needs a little bit more then put it in for a little bit more, and there's no real set time for this. Here it goes into the oven. Now we'll check the cake to see if it's ready. Just open the oven. It's risen very well. I'll check the middle to see if it's baked all the way through, and I'll do that with a knife. And the knife is clean, so it means the cake is ready. If it wasn't ready, you'll still see the cake mixture on the knife, but that's ready. Ready to come out. And as you can see, it's raised quite well. Very happy with the result. I'll let the cake cool down. When it's cooled down, I'll turn it out onto the board that I'm using to decorate the cake with. Okay, welcome back. The cake, as seen in the first bit of the video, is made. Now is the icing of the cake. Now I'm going to use a board. And it's a square board. Now the board is small for the cake, so I need to cut the cake to size to place on the board. So what I'm going to do is turn the sponge cake out of the tin, and I'm going to use the board as a guide on where to cut it. Okay, so I'll just put the cake out onto greaseproof paper. Just give it a little bang, get all the cake out, and hopefully none has stuck to the bottom or the sides. There we go. And there's the cake. Okay, so as I said, the board is not the right size and the cake is bigger than the board, so I'm going to cut it. And I'll use the board as a measurement. I would think that maybe that much can come off. Yeah. So I'll just give it a straight cut. Make sure it's as straight as possible. And there we have surface cake. Maybe later I can icing them into little squares and then have individual cakes. That's something else you can do. So, that's the size cake that I want. I'm also going to take a little trim off here, just to get an equal square line. Just that. And then, just put this cake to the side. When the cake is cut to your satisfaction, the size, put the board, silver part down onto the cake. I'm going to actually icing the other side. So that's the better side, and flip it over. And there we go, just position it on the board as you want it, and that's fine. Make sure it's level, and that's super. Just put that to the side, and then I'll use this surface to roll out the icing. Before I cover the cake, with the icing, I'm going to make some buttercream. And the buttercream will act as an adhesive to the cake and the icing to stick together. So what I'll be using is powdered sugar, some butter, and Philadelphia cream cheese. You don't have to use Philadelphia, but I like the flavour. It's nice and creamy. So, I don't usually weigh out the ingredients for this, as it's a little bit of this and a little bit of that, so it's as you like it. So, if you put too much butter in the ingredients, then you add more powdered sugar and so on. And then you just taste it as you go along. So I don't tend to weigh it out, but I will put the measurements for you and then you'll do it from there. Okay. So this butter is at room temperature, so it's nice and soft. And I'll use 100 grams. It's already marked out on the packet for you there. So I'll just draw the line there and use that. Cream together, and then I will add the powdered sugar. So I'll plug in my hand whisk, so I'll do it by hand, it's easier, quicker. I'll just plug it in. Now I'll add the sugar. The sugar is very fine. You'll probably get the sugar everywhere, so that's why I add a little bit at a time. Okay, just take it from the sides, push it back into the mixture, and then you're ready to go again. And that's ready. Nice, creamy, light and fluffy mixture. Very good. Pleased with that. So, now I'm going to take the buttercream and I'm going to cover the cake in it. The icing. I'm just going to put a little bit of icing sugar on the surface, and that's to stop it from sticking to the surface. Kneading, get it back to a certain consistency. As you're rolling, just turn the icing. Maneuver it around a little bit so covers the whole area of the cake. And then trim the excess off. The black icing with the white in order to get a grey colour. As I'm going to do the collar of the jacket in grey. And here I made a template for the collar. It was actually off a man's shirt. You can go smaller or bigger or wider. And then you cut around the template. And there you have your collar. Now with a stitching tool you can make indentations, like a stitch of a shirt. I have this tool here. And just go around the sides. And it looks like stitching is on the shirt. Excess icing, just brush off. Let's make sure it's on the cake first. Make a little line between the two. These are the buttonholes in the shirt. And then place it where you want it. Some of the already rolled out that you cut away for the collar, and that will act as a buttonhole. And there we go. And that's where the buttons will go. I'll put about three here so you'll see the buttons. Afterwards I'll get a brush and I'll brush it all up. But for now, just get it into place and everything else will be ready. So this cake requires for a red tie and a red handkerchief. So first I'll make the tie. I'm making it freehand. Too long, because it's going to be covered by the jacket, so up to here is fine. Maybe a little shorter. Now for the knot at the top of the tie.
Again, freehand. Just lift the shirt collars up. There you have your red tie. To roll out the black icing for the jacket. Now again I'm doing this freehand. There's no template that I could see to use as a guideline for this jacket, so I'm actually doing it blind and sort of unaware of actually how I'm going to do it. But play by ear. Like I say, I'm doing this freehand, so I'm going to cut a V. And hope that this is okay. Take out the V. Don't be too concerned about tears at the moment, because the collar for the jacket will be going on. Make sure it's all around the sides as well. Cut away the surplus. Almost finished. Now I'm just going to roll out the icing, the black icing again. I'm going to form a collar. Again, freehand.
Now just one piece, one item to go onto the suit and tie and shirt cake, and that is the red handkerchief, which I'm going to place here. First I'll make a little pocket, so I'll give the illusion like the red handkerchief is in a pocket.
Roll out the red icing, the same that I used for the tie, same colour. So you have a matching tie and handkerchief. I'll give it a little triangle handkerchief. Freehand. This is the actual pocket. Make sure it's the right size for the pocket. Just get a little water on the back so it can stick onto the cake. And also on the back of the handkerchief. Let me just... Yeah, that's good enough.
So now everything is finished on the cake, the jacket, the collars, the tie and the handkerchief and the buttons. Now it's just to put the little details on here, on the buttons on the shirt. That's four holes normally on the button. There we go. And then I'm going to do the stitching detail on the pocket and around the edges of the collar. Do it as neat as possible. There you have it. Now for the cleanup, just get a brush, a little paintbrush, get all these icing sugar off and around the collar and the tie and everything. Okay, cake is a little bit cleaner now, just brushing it off, trying to get as much icing off as possible. And what I'm about to do now is put a glaze on the cake to make it look shiny. Nice shiny suit. And I'm using sugar syrup to make the glaze, to make the shine. So, this is my sugar syrup, just an ordinary paintbrush. And this is the final product of the shirt, jacket, tie and handkerchief birthday cake. I've added the initials of the birthday boy and used it as a label from the shirt. And like I said, to add the finishing touches, I glazed it with sugar syrup to make it look shiny. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Feel free to comment on this cake or any other cakes that I have on YouTube. Thank you so much for watching and all your likes.